All new Turtle Wax Hybrid Solutions Ceramic Acrylic Black Wax.
Hey guys, in this product of the week video, we're diving deep into the Turtle Wax Ceramic Acrylic Black Wax. It's a new wax, a part of their Hybrid Solutions line that came out last October, I believe. And this is particularly for black paint. I actually posted a video on their Ceramic Acrylic Black Polish a few days ago. I'll link that up in a YouTube card here if you guys want to check that out before this video. But before we do anything, let's go ahead and read the description and directions as always in every product of the week video that we're going to be doing here. And guys, real fast before we get into this, comment below yes if you want to see this black acrylic ceramic wax next to their ceramic spray that they came out in their Hybrid Solutions line. So again, in the comments below, if you want to see this put to the test as a dual kind of chemical water test next to their other ceramic spray, comment yes in the comment section below. So it says right here, this black wax increases depth of color, gloss, and protection for black paint finishes, adds slickness for easy application and removal, black pigmented polish and carnauba wax fills light imperfections and leaves a deep, rich black shine. And the SiO2 and acrylic polymers produces a durable layer that repels water, harsh chemicals, helps prevent permanent water stains for months. Basically, all of that is a fancy way of saying it's gonna make the black paint look really shiny and nice. It might fill in some of those small kind of hairline swirls and scratches, and it's gonna be very durable as far as chemicals and water is concerned, which we're gonna be looking at both of those things. Now, just to make sure that I'm following the directions to a T here, it says wash and dry car, shake well. For best results, do not over apply. For more cleaning and fill, allow to lightly haze. Now here, it can be used on wheels, exterior trim and plastics, but do not use on convertible tops. Allow the paint to cure for 24 hours before washing or applying an additional coat. Okay, that's all we need to know here. Let's go ahead and look at this black paint we're using it on. All right guys, now full disclosure here, you guys can see this is a hood, a minivan hood. This left side is taped off here to the right side. This is probably about a little more than a third of the hood here. This was polished with the ceramic acrylic black polish maybe a few days ago, about a week ago actually. And then I applied the ceramic acrylic black wax to the polished surface. I let it cure for 24 hours. I then applied a second coat after 24 hours. So technically speaking, this part of the hood here already has one layer that's cured for 24 hours and another layer of the ceramic acrylic black wax that has cured for probably about, let's say, 48 hours now. So I am going to apply this just to show you how it applies to the surface, but just know this is going to be the third coat. So this is just gonna be additional protection, kind of giving the benefit of the doubt to the product here. Now, once again, it says not to over apply it. So all I do is two kind of light sprays on this area. So I'll show you what that looks like here. About just like that. So that's like barely any product. I'll take my microfiber towel here and I'm going to apply it kind of in a crosshatch pattern. And again, I don't really need as much product because this is the third time I'm applying this, but just know that this paint has had plenty of time to cure, so we're giving all of the benefit of the doubt to the product itself. Now, not over applying it is a super important little part of this because it can be pretty difficult to apply, or I'm sorry, to take off rather, if you apply too much. So I've been taking two sprays to the paint every single time. This third time was even lighter, and this is the easiest to remove that it's been. So even with two sprays, it can be a little bit difficult to remove. So I will say, just make sure you follow those directions because the directions obviously caution you there for good reason. So there we go. Now what I want to do before anything is just take a good light here so we can see what the paint looks like as far as swirls, scratches are concerned, because not only has this been polished, and you guys can see right here what the paint looked like before anything happened. You see all those swirls, all those paint imperfections. It looks terrible in the sun here. And this is what it looks like after I actually applied the polish with a medium cut foam pad and a light black polishing pads. This is a two-step correction here you're looking at, and this is the final result with the ceramic acrylic black polish. So that looks fantastic. Now let's go ahead and look at it under the light after the ceramic has been applied and cured to see if we can see any differences. So one of the things you guys are gonna be able to see here are the deeper scratches, watermarks, etchings that are deeper into the clear coat that are not going to be removed with a simple polish like this. But you can see kind of that dramatic, if you can even rewind back in the video, see what that looked like before. I mean, this is a
certainly a dramatic after, and I would say yes, that ceramic wax did fill in even further some of those hairline swirls. So there's not really even any what I would call kind of what looked like hologramming left, which were those lighter hairline swirls. So let's go ahead and look at the water behavior here. You guys can see it's pretty much exactly what you would expect as far as the beading. I would say this is certainly something that kind of beads more than it sheets, just to get into the nitty-gritty of it all. Not a lot of water left on the paint after I stop kind of, you know, blowing it on there with my air compressor. But again, I'd say that there's nothing too revolutionary about what we're seeing right now. This is pretty much exactly what I would have expected. Again, this is two different layers cured 24 hours apart, and the second layer cured for about 48 to 72 hours. So anyway, this is what the other side looks like, just to give you guys a bit of a reference point that's not coated. But what I want to do here is put some super clean degreaser on it. This is full strength, so you would never do this in the real world, but again, we're just kind of pushing the limits of the chemical resistance here. So I'm so soaking it in that degreaser full strength. You can see, letting it sit for a second. I'm going to wipe it off kind of in a crosshatch-esque pattern here. So kind of wipe it off with my microfiber towel, come back in, rinse it with my pressure washer, and then I'm going to dry it. But I also want to take a waterless wash and spray that onto the paint to pull off any residue that's left from the degreaser, because that will affect those hydrophobic properties that we see in the moment, even if it didn't affect the coating itself. So here's what it looks like after all that residue is removed from the degreaser. Now, I'm going to let you guys kind of judge this for whatever you're seeing. I think you could even go back and forth in the video to compare what we're seeing here. But I think that it is probably safe to say certain properties of the coating, even those three layers that have been curing, of course that last layer was applied just in the midst of this video, but those two layers that have been curing certainly have been affected, but not at a level that's crazy. Now, this is an alkaline wheel cleaner. It's not an acid wheel cleaner. It's from Jax Wax. It's called their HD wheel cleaner. It's fantastic, but it was on my shelf, and it's a really strong, strong wheel cleaner. So I wanted to add that on here on top of the degreaser. So again, same process, blowing it off with my air compressor, blowing it off with my pressure washer, not my air compressor, rinsing it. I'm going to take my waterless wash, get off the residue, rinse it one more time, dry it one more time. And then we're going to look at the after results here. And again, I'd like you guys to be the judge, but I think it's probably safe to say with this second pass of just another alkaline cleaner, that coating is degrading further and further. And while you can't really isolate for the variable of, you know, which product degraded it more, because this is being applied after the degreaser was applied, so you could probably make an argument, hey, the degreaser kind of hurt this coating, degraded this coating, and then the wheel cleaner came in and just delivered that second punch to a coating that was already weakened. I think that is probably a powerful argument. But in the midst of that, even in the midst of some of those hydrophobic properties, you know, I think there is an obvious difference from the beginning to where we are now. Even so, you can still see that coating repelling water at a high level and kind of more or less sheeting it off more. That water's kind of congregating and sheeting off more than it was before. So still very, very impressive. But again, here's the results. I'll let you guys kind of come to your own conclusions with this.
All right, guys, that's it. There's kind of a full in-depth look at this product. If you want to get your hands on this product, I'll hook up an Amazon link in the YouTube description box below, as well as links to anything else I used in this video. Also, guys, let me know in the comments if you enjoy the product of the week segment here that I've been starting, where we take a really deep dive, kind of in-depth look at specific products like this one, kind of tearing them apart, seeing how they react in different situations. These kind of videos get much less views than others, but I think it attracts a certain person like myself who wants to know all of the details and really get a full understanding, and that's why I do them. So let me know in the comments if you like this type of video. Guys, thank you so much for being involved. Really, really, I appreciate it. As always, if you have not yet subscribed to the Wilson Auto Detailing community, hit the red subscribe button and hit the bell icon so you don't miss any future videos that come out just like this. And as always, from Luke here at Wilson Auto Detailing, keep working hard, and I'll see you guys in the next video.